Hi guys, I know we are all under restricted movement until 31st of March, so I don't want you guys to miss out on your classes and your studies, so Mr. Kenny has no choice but to create videos for you guys so that you would study and continue on the lessons, and SVM Biology is coming quite close to us and your exams are near, so let's continue studies even though you're at home. So kindly, for all my students, kindly take out your notes. Take out the leaflets, okay, that I've given out. Okay, the whole stack of notes that I've given out to you guys. So can you please open to where we last stopped? And today we will be focusing on, continuing on the endocrine system. All right. So a short recap of what we learned in the previous class was that Form 5, Chapter 3, coordination, we learned two systems: nervous system, endocrine system. They are all involved in coordinating activities in the body. So nervous system teaches about the fast, nervous system controls the fast responses, correct? Brain wants to tell the hand to move, we move immediately. Whereas the endocrine system controls the slower response. Grow, take your time to grow. Understand? So today we'll look at the endocrine system, which is made up of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 glands: pituitary, thyroid, pancreas, adrenal, ovaries, and testes. Now, what do they all do and why are they scattered everywhere? So what they all do is they secrete hormones. This is what they do. They secrete hormones. And what are hormones? Hormones are basically the message. Remember, in nervous system, the message is in the form of nerve impulses. But for endocrine glands, the message are in the form of hormones. Okay, so today we'll be just focusing on the pituitary gland first, just a trial video. So let's hope everything goes okay. I hope you guys are having your notes in front of you, really write the answers down. For those who don't have, you can just listen, or you can just copy down in a white piece and or white sheet of paper. All right. Now we can start off with pituitary gland all the way up. Okay, at the base of the brain. Now, what is the function of pituitary gland? Sometimes they call it as the master gland. Why is it called the master? Because it controls the activities of other glands in the body to secrete hormones or to function, to carry out their functions. So let's look here. The pituitary gland, you have two parts: anterior pituitary and the posterior pituitary gland. Now in SVM, you do not need to know anterior or posterior. You don't have to go so detailed. Okay? But I'm just splitting it up since it's in part of one of your revision books, so I'm just going to open it up. So the anterior pituitary gland will secrete 6 hormones over here, and the posterior will secrete 2 hormones here. Again, hormones are chemical messages. Okay? Now, let's look at the first one, thyroid stimulating hormone. Okay, let's write this one down first. Short for TSH, short for FSH, short for LH, short for GH, this one ACTH, and this prolactin, VRL. Okay, so let's start off with thyroid stimulating hormone. This class, I'm going to make it very, very simple in this video, but if there's any details, I can share it in class later, alright? Now, what we look at are the hormones. Where do they go to? The target. And what is the function? Simple. There's a lot of words in the book. I'm just going to simplify everything for you so that you understand it more first. Okay, so we start off TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. Now, what is the function? Sure, don't know, exam. Okay, the word stimulate. What do you think this hormone do? It stimulates which gland in the body? Thyroid. Okay, the thyroid gland, for example. Pituitary gland will secrete TSH. What's the use? Thyroid stimulating. So of course they will go to the thyroid gland and stimulate, say, oi, do something. So what do? You stimulate thyroid gland to secrete this hormone known as thyroxine. We will go into thyroxine when we reach the next video. Alright? Now, next we look at follicle stimulating hormone. FSH. Now FSH, what's the function? Again, pituitary will secrete FSH. And where do they go to? They go all the way down here. Ovaries and testes. Male and female and male. Oh, sorry. In ovaries and testes, in females and male. Now, follicle stimulating hormone. Teacher, what is this follicle thing? Well, students ask, is it hair follicles? No, nothing to do with follicles. Okay? These follicles are talked about as reproductive cells. Okay? All the way, actually we call it reproductive cells. They are cells found in the ovaries and the testes. We will go into more detail of the follicle cells when we reach reproduction chapter. Okay, so for now, they stimulate the cells down there, follicles. What's the use? Stimulate them to develop. Grow is to just increase in size, increase in mass. Develop is to change in complexity. Correct? So, develop the follicles, and later we'll learn that follicles will in turn secrete the hormone called estrogen. Okay, next. FSH in males will stimulate this process called spermatogenesis. Genesis is starting off the production of spermatozoa or sperm cells. Okay, so start the production of sperm cells. Again, we'll go to this in chapter 4, reproductive chapter. Alright, next hormone, LH. Luteinizing hormone secreted here. Again, we'll go all the way down. Here, so they'll secrete ovaries and testes, always going down here. Okay, some of you like that. Okay, go to the ovaries and what does it do? Make sure you know this is a very, very important function that will be asked every time. LH is important, okay, to stimulate this production called ovulation. I think if you remember in Form 3 or Form 1 where you learn reproduction, okay, ovulation is a process where the ovum, okay, or right now they call it ovum. Okay, later we call it a secondary oocyte. The ovum will be released out from the ovary into the fallopian tube, waiting to be fertilized. Okay, next, how about in males? In males, it will stimulate the cells down here, the testes, to secrete a hormone called testosterone, the male sex hormone. Okay, next, we move into the last one that is very important for SPM. Growth hormone. The word itself, the name itself is growth. So we would know something to do with growth. Now when I say you grow taller, hey, our boy grow taller already. What does it mean? It means that your bones have lengthened, your muscles have become longer and become bigger. So when it goes to growth hormone, think of your bones and your tissues. Yeah? So growth hormone will target them. So again, this one has no special gland it goes to. It goes to every other part as long as your tissues and your bones will stimulate them for what? For growth. Very direct answer. Okay? Now, and then we go into these two hormones over here, which I'll just grow very, very quickly. Okay? Prolactin, again, secreted out. Okay? Prolactin will stimulate the mammary glands. What are mammary glands? Mammary glands are the glands found in the breast of female. Okay, so stimulate them to secrete milk or stimulate milk production and to secrete milk. Okay, next is the ACTH, will secrete another hormone, ACTH, that I'm just going through very briefly because at same level we don't have to go so detail. So ACTH for level, it goes all the way down to the adrenal glands. Now what is adrenal cortex here? Now adrenal glands, you see the two center claws head on top of the kidneys. Alright, inside the adrenal gland, you have two main parts. The outer part is the cortex, the inner part is called the medulla. Okay, so it stimulates the outer part to release more hormones, which thankfully you guys don't have to know for your exam. If you want to know, you can come to class and ask me. Okay, now, then we are done with the six hormones here. And then, now let's move on to these two hormones. I think the lighting's a bit kacau. Let me change a bit. Alright, so for posterior pituitary gland, two hormones, oxytocin and ADH. Now, what's the function of oxytocin? Oxytocin, it targets smooth muscles. Now, remember smooth muscles? Smooth muscles are involuntary muscles found in the uterus in the reproductive system of the female. Okay, so why do we target this muscle for? What's the function of muscle? Muscle is to contract and relax, correct? So it stimulates them to contract during childbirth. So let's say when the fetus is growing in there, okay, when they're about to give birth, the pituitary gland will secrete oxytocin all the way down to uterus muscle to contract to push the baby out. Okay, and then we go to this hormone here, another important hormone. So okay, please star all these hormones. Okay, these are more important for your SPM. Now we go to antidiuretic hormone, also known as ADH. Please know this hormone because it will be spread in later part of this chapter. Okay, now let's go into the name of it. Okay, diuretic comes from the word diuresis. Diuresis means production of urine. production of urine. So anti means you do not produce urine or produce lesser urine, correct? So ADH, okay, production of lesser urine. What is that for? Okay, so let's go to where do they target. They target your kidney tubules. Where's your kidney tubules? Your kidney is here. Inside there is made up of many millions of tubes in here. Now, what's the whole point of these tubes? These tubes are supposed to channel excessive water, excessive salt, excessive water, salt, and urea out from your body. Now, let's say if you do not drink enough water, okay? This water will go to your kidneys and will be drained out. So it's dangerous, right? Because not enough water in your system. So what does your body do? Your body has your pituitary gland here will secrete this hormone to protect you from drying out. So you secrete anti-diuretic hormone. So ADH will come all the way down here. So what do? You stimulate them to reabsorb the water back. So remember, when you reabsorb the water back into your body, so what will happen? You produce lesser urine. Understand? So it prevents you from getting dehydrated from excessive water loss. Understand? So this is all for one gland. Alright, so pituitary, six, how do you remember? Ant, you've got six legs. Six legs. Anterior, six hormones, posterior, postman, two legs. Two hormones. Understand? Okay, so it's just a way to know where they're located, but it's not so important. Again, the function and where do they target is more important. And then from here, I will use this as a base to teach you how to answer SPM question to target on them. Okay, when we do exercises, keep this, I will teach you again one more time. Okay, if you want to draw this out, feel free to draw it. The more you draw, the more you rewrite, the more it sticks in your mind. So stop here, I'll see you in the next class.